Good morning, everybody. Welcome and hello to a further practical learning session with the topic Room Temperature Control and Additional RTC Functions, Part 2. My name is Thorsten Reibel from the Competence Center Eurosmart Buildings. Yeah, Additional Functions, Part 2. So we have done already Part 1 in the last week, but still some additional functions are left, like weighting of temperature measurements in a room, or summer compensation, valve purge, and some more. So we will do this today, again, with a small practical part, but mainly a demonstration with ETS and also the ABB iBus tool. And yeah, it takes around half an hour, I hope, I think, and I hand over to Jürgen right now.
Hello and welcome to this practical learning session, ClimaEcho, ABB iBus KNX and HVAC. My name is Jürgen Schilder. Today I will show you the practical application of the additional RTC functions part 2 for heating and cooling in a room with the fan coil controller FCCS and the room temperature controller Tenton. The additional functions are weighting of the temperature inputs, summer compensation, valve purge and manual override, fan speed limitations, fan speed start-up and run-on behavior. After an introduction on our ABB ClimaEcho HVAC solutions, I show you the parameterization in the ETS and then live the function in operation. The focus is on a live demonstration and I'm only showing you some slides at the beginning. ABB offers a holistic automation solution for heating, ventilation and air conditioning based on ABB iBus KNX. This allows a seamless integration from the room level via distribution and central HVAC functions to the management and automation level. This is a significant step towards increasing energy efficiency and reducing the operating costs. The ABB ClimaEcho portfolio includes the room operating elements, the actuators that control the valve drives and regulate the cold and the hot water flow. Additional, the devices for the distribution of the heating and cooling, like with the heating cooling circuit controller, ACCS, the boiler chiller interface, application controller with the interface to BACnet, and the building automation controller, KNX, BACS, the PLC with KNX interface. We have given numerous webinars about all these products. You can find the slides and videos of these sessions in our training and qualification database. Here you can see an overview of the HVAC KNX range devices. On the left side, we have the room operating elements, different designs with the temperature sensor inside or also with the controller built inside. In the middle, we have the actuators are also controllers, like here, 9 different types of fan coil controllers, the valve drive controllers, or special devices like for hotel applications, the room master or the room controller. And on the right side, we have the devices for the distribution or also for the management or for the top level here with these devices. Today we put the focus on the fan coil controller and valve drive controller functions because the devices have the similar functions built inside, like the weighting of the temperature inputs and also the valve purge. So the devices today works together with a room temperature controller here with the design Tenton, for example. This is exactly the exercise we want to do. We have here a typical office, a room, and we want to use here heating and cooling in the room with the fan coil controller FCCS. He works as a controller. And in the room, we have the control element Tenton, which works as a slave. And with the rockers, we want to do some functions, like, for example, changing the set point via the rockers, switch on and off, change the operating mode between Echo and Comfort, the fan speed manual, and with one button, we want to activate the valve purge. And with the other buttons, we want to use the manual override for the valve output A, like enable or disable, and set here the value. And with the other buttons, we want to use the fan limitations, fan limitation 1 in the sleeping mode, and with the fan limitation 2, like the room isn't occupied. This is only example, yeah, because I don't want to use another control element, and we can use these buttons here to activate or deactivate the functions. So we have built inside the room a fan coil unit, which works in a 4-pipe system. And we want to do now these different additional functions, like the weighting of the room temperature, the summer compensation, the valve purge, and also the limitations. some words about the weighting of a temperature input. What does it mean? So for example, we have different zones in an open off office or here like in a room. So we can measure on different points the temperature, and then we can weight in this temperature and use it for calculation of the set point. On the fan coil controller, we can use the temperature which comes like from the room temperature sensor via KNX. Also, we can use temperatures which are connected to the inputs of the device. And then we can use here the parameters for weighting. The summer computation is used to save energy and it's mandatory in some regions. So depending on the outside temperature, the set point for the comfort cooling in the comfort mode is now shifted. So we need here additional temperature sensor outside, and then you can see the temperature outside is rising, and in the room the set point in the comfort mode cooling is then also increased. So the valve purge means that is prevented the stinging of the valve during non-heating or cooling time periods. Like in the summer, we don't use the heating functions, and then we can trigger it automatically via internal timer or via KNX, so that every 4 weeks the valve for heating opens and cool and closes automatically. So this is what we want to do, and also the manual override. So via a KNX telecom, we can override the control value. Like for example, for commissioning or for maintenance or for tests, yeah, it is possible to override the calculated value. So we need a 1-bit information, we can activate it, and then via a 1-byte, we can send now this manual override value. Then you will see the fan and also the valve follows exactly here this manual value. So then we come to the fan coil controller special functions, like here the fan operation mode. So very important, you have to look in the technical data sheet of the fan, of the motor, how it works, like in a changeover switch. Then you will see that only fan speed number one, the output one, is on, and the fan speed number two, only the output B, and the fan speed C, only the output C. Or here in the step switch, you see here then the difference. This is what you have to check in the manual. So, but what we want to use is the typical fan speed limitation functions. So we have up to 3 limitations. And when we activate a limitation via 1-bit telegram, maybe via time switch or the key card reader, like when you leave the hotel room, then the limitation is activated. So that, for example, the fan speed runs in a special limit, like here, between the limit 1 and 3. So we have every time a kind of continuous air circulation in the room. Or during the sleeping mode in the night, the fan goes only maximal in fan speed number 2. It can be off, 1 or 2. It cannot go in this fan speed number 3 to reduce the noise in the hotel room. So this is a nice feature of the limitations, and the limitation 1 has a higher priority than the limitation 2 or 3. So the typical startup behaviors, also something which you have to read in the technical data sheet of the motor if it's really required. And then we can activate this startup behavior, and then we can set here a value between 0 100%, or when we use the fan coil controller with the 3 speeds output, then we can define here fan speed 1, 2 or 3. So what does it mean? There is a command switch on up to fan speed number 2, but the motor starts in the fan speed number 3 for a special time, the minimum dwell time can be set as a parameter, and then he goes into the specific speed, like in fan speed 1 or 2, which is calculated. So then we have additional function, so-called run-on behavior. This means that the fan stays in the current level if a lower level is required. So for example, when he's in the fan speed number 3, and then we switch off the fan, by pressing, for example, the off button of the controller, then he stays in the fan speed number 3 for several seconds, fan speed number 2 and fan speed number 1 to blow out the remaining heat or cold from the fan coil unit. This is also a feature which I want to show you later. Good, then let's start with our exercise. So here you can see exactly our room. We use here the fan coil controller, FCCS. On the output, we have a fan coil unit, the 4-pipe system, valve for heating, valve for cooling, and the 3-step fan with the speed off 0, 1, 2, and 3. Connected to the inputs, we have here maximum 4 inputs available. One input is used for the window contact to get the information window is open or closed, and for the temperature sensor, which is maybe connected nearby the entrance area of the room. So we want to use a weighting. So what does it mean? We need a second sensor, temperature sensor, which is installed here in our room control element. He sent then also the actual temperature of this area, maybe nearby the window, and inside we use a weighting function. So that 50% of this temperature sensor and 50% of this temperature is used to calculate the actual value. And this actual value temperature is then used for calculation the control value. So the 50-50 of this input and 50% of this what comes via KNX. So what else? We want to use the summer compensation. So what does it mean? We need an outside temperature sensor, which sends here the temperature as a 2-byte temperature value to our fan coil controller. So this is typically which used from a weather station or maybe other device, the outside temperature sensor. So to activate the valve purge, I use here one button, the button number 10 with a 1-bit telegram. I can trigger it with the value 1 or 0 to trigger here the valve purge. In the real installation, maybe you will do it via time switch, for example. And via the first two buttons, I want to use this override function. So maybe for maintenance. So when I press here on the left side, I activate now this override function with the value 1. And with the second button here, I send a control value. Like here, for example, 40 with so-called alternating 40%, next time 80%, 40%, 80%. And then this has a higher priority than as the calculated control value here inside. Then we will see the behavior on the output. So this is exactly what we want to do. And with the with the next buttons here, button number 3 and 4, I want to activate this fan limitation. With the left side, so-called sleeping mode, that the fan goes only in the speed 0, 1, or 2. And on the right side, I want to activate the fan limitation 2, like the unoccupied mode. So when you leave the hotel room, that he always stays in the fan speed 1, 2, or 3. It cannot be possible that a fan stops or goes to speed number 0. Good, then let's do exactly the exercise, and I show you now the parameterization and the ETS. So here I have prepared an ETS project with the fan coil controller FCCS with the 3-speed motor and thermoelectric valve outputs. On the right side, you can still see here the exercise, what we want to do. Then I start with setting the parameters of the fan coil controller. So at first, I start with the first parameters in the basic settings. So I can use here all these default parameters that you can see when I change a parameter, I activate now here this function highlight changes. So now when I change here a parameter, then you will see it becomes here highlighted in yellow. So it's easier then to follow my steps. Okay, here basic settings, we can use all the default parameters. Yes, we want to use the full access to the iBus tool. Okay, then we keep the parameters and also here the other one. Manual operation, the same. Yes, we want to use, of course, the manual operation. So then we come to the parameters application. So we use the controller function in the fan coil controller, though we keep here the parameter UR controller. For basic stage heating, we use water heating coil in the fan coil unit. Yes, it's correct. No additional stage heating. Then we come to the cooling, basic stage cooling. Yes, also water cooling fan coil. So we can keep this parameter, and again, no additional stage cooling. So we have a heating cooling system of a 4-pipe system. Yes, so we can also use this parameter, and the changeover between heating and cooling should be automatic or via group object. No, we say here as default automatic. Then we come to the valve outputs. For the basic stage heating, we use the valve output A. Yes, it's okay. And for the basic stage cooling, we use the second output, the valve output B. Also okay, then we use the parameters. So then we come to the window status. So the window open or close. The window contact is connected to one of our inputs. So we can select here via physical device input. So we use here one of these 4 inputs and say, okay, you are a window contact. So dew point sensor or fill level sensor is not connected, but we have connected here a temperature sensor. Then we can activate here actual temperature received via physical device input. Yes, so we can here activate this one, or in our case, we want to do the weighting. Then we have to activate here, we have to set the parameter via physical device input. Yes, and or via group object. Yeah, because we want to do the weighting. So 50% comes here from our room control element. And then we can set here parameter. How many group objects we use? Only one or two? So if we have another of this element in our room, which sends also a temperature. But in our exercise, we say no, we have only one group object for receiving the temperature. And then we can set here the weighting of the internal measurement and our external, which comes from our control element. We want to use the 50-50%. So then we set here 50% of the internal measurement and 50% of the external measurement. And then later you will see if this one measures here 20 degrees, the room control element in the other corner of the room measures 22, and 20 plus 22 equals 42 divided by 2, then we get here an actual temperature of 21 degrees. So this is the middle of both. So you can also select here maybe 75 and 25 or 75 and 50, but in my exercise I want to use very easy 50-50. So then we come to the temperature controller. And the temperature controller, we can use here the settings as they are as default for cyclical sending of the room temperature and so on. The basic stage heating, we can use here exactly the standard settings. If you want, you can activate the extended settings for sending the control value every 50 minutes or the difference for sending. The same here for basic stage cooling. So the type of the control here for the basic stage heating or cooling depends our settings we have made in the menu application. We selected fan coil unit and then use exactly here the P and the I value for the fan coil unit. So then we come to the next one, our set point manager. Here we can select our available operating modes. Typically, a room temperature controller has four operating modes: comfort, standby, echo, building protection. So we can say, yes, we want all four, or we want to use only three or two of these modes. So then we can set here the mode after bus voltage recovery, our set points, the comfort set point, like here 21 degrees, for heating, for cooling 25, and our relative set points for standby and for the echo mode. So here we have, for example, two Kelvins. What does it mean? We have now comfort cooling set point 25 degrees, and then our standby is 25 plus 2 Kelvins, 27 Kelvins. These are so-called the relative set points. So what else? We want to use the summer compensation. Then, of course, here we have to activate the summer compensation. So summer compensation, we have to enter here the starting temperature when the summer compensation should start. This is the outside temperature. Like, for example, I have here in my exercise 30 degrees. So when we have outside a temperature more than 30 degrees, he starts with shifting the set point for the cooling mode. So here we have then to enter the offset when he starts at 30 degrees, maybe keep it here as zero, and the ending temperature for the summer compensation, like in my exercise 38 degrees, and the set point temperature offset when he reach this 38 degrees, like for example 4 Kelvins. So what does it mean now? So we start with the increasing our set point temperature at 30 degrees up to 38, and when outside we have a set point, we have an outside temperature of 38 degrees, we will have a set point temperature of 34. Yeah, so 38 minus 4, then he change here of these 4 Kelvins. Good, then we come to monitoring and safety. So no forced operation. This was the topic of the last practical learning session. So then we can use the default settings. Then we come to the valve purge. So in the output, we have our thermoelectric valve drives. Valve output A is for heating, so-called pulse width modulation or open close. No, best thing is to use the pulse width modulation. Then we have to enter here the pulse width modulation cycle time. In the real installation, maybe for example for a thermoelectric valve drive, which is used for radiator, we will have 15 minutes, and for a floor heating system, for example, 30 minutes. What does it mean? In this time slot of this 15 minutes, the valve opens 20% and closes 80% if there is a control value of 20%. So I use here only 10 seconds for this pulse width modulation time and only 10 seconds for the valve drive and opening closing time to show you later exactly this behavior. So we can also enter here time because the valve needs maybe in a real installation 1 or up to 2 minutes for opening and closing the valve. So I use here only for demonstration 10 seconds. So then we want to use the manual override function. So we have to say yes, manual override, and then we get our group objects for this override function. So, and we want to use also the valve purge. So valve purge, we can trigger it via group object, via time switch, for example, or it can be triggered automatically. Yeah, so automatically, maybe every 4 weeks. Yeah, or for example, when he reaches maybe more than 99%, 100%, he starts also with the resetting the counter for the for this valve purge function. And if we want to send here also the status, if he's active, then we can say yes after change or on request. So in the same settings, we can do here for our cooling valve, like here also 10 seconds for the pulse width modulation time, enable the manual override, and also here then the status. Good, then we come to the fan parameterization. Fan, remember, we want to use the startup behavior. At first, we can enter here the mode if it works in the changeover or in a step switch mode. Remember, read the technical data sheet of the fan. So then we can enter here the thresholds value for switching in the different fan speeds. So when we have a control value higher than 1, then he goes in fan speed number 1, higher than 30, fan speed number 2, more than 70, fan speed number 3, the hysteresis time, for example, the minimum dwell time. This is possible here. So then we want to activate the startup behavior. So we have here the parameter. Startup behavior means when the fan is off and he will be switched on, then this will be active automatically. So we say yes. So then we have to enter here the fan speed number 3, 2 or 1. So in my exercise, when we switch on the fan, control value greater than 0%, then he should go into fan speed number 3. The minimum dwell time means then he will stay 5 seconds in this fan speed number 3, and then he will go to the calculated fan speed like 1 or 2. So this is exactly the principle of the startup. Start with fan speed number 3, always remains 5 seconds, and then go to the lower fan speed like calculated. So the run on behavior, there's a function here. Run on means if the motor should go to a lower fan speed, but then he remains exactly this time, like here default 20 seconds for the speed from speed number 1 to off, fan speed number 2 to 1, and fan speed number 3 to 2. So my example, when we are in the fan speed number 3 and we want to go to the fan speed number 2, there should be no run on behavior. So I enter here 0. So now then he will go immediately from fan speed number 3 to fan speed number 2. So but from fan speed number 2 to fan speed number 2 to 1, if there is a command, then I enter here 2 seconds, then he will stay longer 2 seconds in the fan speed number 2, and then he goes in fan speed number 1. And the same when we are in fan speed number 1 and there's an off command and I enter here 4, then he will remain 4 seconds to blow the cold or the hot air out of the fan coil unit. So I enter here, for example, 4 seconds. So this is exactly my example. Good, so far these are the run-on behavior, startup behavior, and so on. Good, so what else? The limitations. I want to use also the limitations of the fan. So where are the limitations? Send. Limitations here. Limitation of fan speed. I say yes, activate it. Then I have here 3 limitations. Fan limitation 1 has the higher priority than 2 or 3. Limitation 1 is used, in my exercise, for the sleeping mode, like in a hotel room. So in the hotel room, it's only allowed that the fan runs in the speed off, or he's off, and runs in the fan speed 1 or 2. It is not possible that the motor goes into the fan speed number 3. This is typically sleeping mode during the night. You want to sleep, and the fan goes only maximum in fan speed number 2. So maybe you deactivate the limitation 1 in the morning via time switch, and then he can go in fan speed number 3. Limitation 2 is used here in my example, so-called unoccupied mode. So unoccupied means I can select here the range. So unoccupied, it is only possible that the motor runs in the fan speed 1, 2 or 3. It is not possible to switch off the motor. So we have a kind of natural ventilation here in our room. Good, and limitation 3, maybe at the moment I don't use it. So then let's come to the relay output, the additional relay, which is here to switch maybe additional heater or use it for other function. Yeah, it's deactivated, it's not used. Then I can reduce here the parameters and also the group objects. Set point adjustment, I can also keep it like it is. Yeah, the increase or the reduction of the set point in the heating or in the cooling mode. So I keep here also these parameters. So remember, we have connected a window contact. So then we have to select which input he is connected. He is, for example, connected here in my training board to my input number A. The advantage is when we use here this internal function, we have not to link group addresses. There's an internal communication between this input and the controller. And on input number C, I have connected here this temperature sensor. Then I select here temperature sensor and select here the type like PT1000 or PT100 or KTY. It depends on your hardware. And again, this is here the internal communication. We need no group addresses for linking the input here to our controller. Good, so far, these are the settings. Then let's have a look on the group objects. Here you are the group objects of the fan coil controller. Then you can see, for example, here the group object 23, 24, 25. This is here the limitation. Limitation 1, 2, 3 with the value 1, we can enable it. With the value 0, disable. Or the valve purge is object number 31 to activate the valve purge. And the status of the valve purge is here the object 29. The weighting of our temperature inputs is here with the object number, where is it? I have to scroll down. 76. This temperature comes here from our room temperature sensor. So this is the external via KNX. And then he uses the internal temperature of the binary of this input here, and then he makes the weighting and use this actual temperature for calculation our control value, and this is also then maybe sent to KNX or to send this temperature value to the display and show here the actual temperature in the display of the room operating elements. So, and the summer compensation is here. So we have to link here the outside temperature to this object. And then we have here, for example, also then the status if it's active or inactive. Good. Next step is to link the group addresses between the room control element, room operating element, and the fan coil controller. That's what I like to show you now in the ETS. So on the left side, you can see the fan coil controller. On the right side, we have our control element. And then we start with linking the group addresses. We have here the master-slave communication. So you have to link all the group objects according to the master-slave communication between the master and the slave. Additionally, or especially, we need here the external temperature for the weighting and use the actual temperature to display it here in our room operating element. So then we want to enable and disable the manual override with the button number 1. We've sent here 1-bit object for enable, disable, and via the status object, and via another object, we have to send here the value. So in the ETS, I have to parameterize here 40 or 80%, and then he sent here the control value to override the calculated control value. For the limitation, I use here the button number 3 on this side and for limitation 2 on the right side. So you need also here group address for activation, the limitation with the value 1. To activate the valve purge, I use here the button 10 with the value 1. It is activated, or with 0, it is kind of triggered. And then via the object status, he sent back if the valve purge is active and can indicate it here on the LED. And do not forget, for the outside temperature must be linked here to the object outside temperature of the summer compensation. And then we have numerous status objects which can be sent to KNX to display it maybe on a room touch or on a visualization or somewhere else, like the status heating cooling mode or the status of the window contact and so on. Good, then let's go to the ETS and do it in practical for the next practical demonstration. So the next step is to link the group addresses, make a download, but I have done exactly all the steps. I have linked group addresses and made now a download. So we can continue and start with the practical demonstration. So the first step is, after download, go to the device and start here the manual operation via this button and test now the fan and the valve drives. So now you see the yellow LED is on. We are now in the manual mode and I can press now here the button and start the fan. Fan speed number 3, test the run-on behavior. Yes, so he starts with speed number 3 and then he goes in fan speed number 1. Next time I press the button, he goes in fan speed number 2, fan speed number 3. So by using this manual operation, I can test the wiring of the fan, if the supply voltage of the fan is okay, and so on. And then again, I press here, then he goes back to fan speed number 2, 2 seconds, it remains 4 seconds, and then he switches off. So I can test here also now the run-on behavior. Or via this button here, I select now here the A, then I see here the status output A is off. By pressing here this button, I can send the control value 100%, and then you see the output A, the valve opens. So I can test here also the wiring of the valve. Yeah, and click on this button, I send the control value 0, you see the valve close. When I select here the output B is for my cooling valve, I can do the same, click here on the button, and then I see, yes, my valve drive for cooling now opens, and now here close. So by using this manual operation, I can test here the fan, I can test my valve drives, and I can test also here my binary input. So now when I open the window, then you can see the status, the LED is on, or not, then you can see, yes, the window contact works. Also, very nice feature here, the manual operation. So I always recommend to use devices with this manual operation to test the connected hardware. So then we can go to the ETS. We can do some diagnostics here, for example, in the group monitor is possible, like the weighting of the temperature. I can simulate with this control element here temperature, like, for example, when I press on this button, you see here, this is a temperature which comes from my, normally from my room temperature controller, but I simulate it here via a sensor, like 20 degrees. And then I change here, for example, the temperature input. This is my second temperature. Remember, I want to do the weighting 50-50%. So now I have here 20 degrees from my room temperature controller. This here is my input. You see here, 25 degrees. Plus 20 divided by 2 gives here our results in our 22.8 degrees. So we have a weighting of 50% of my input number C and my external temperature. Or when I reduce this temperature, like for example to here, so this is my temperature sensor which is connected here to my input, and then you will see he calculates a new actual temperature. So we have to wait a little bit. At the moment I have 22 degrees, which comes from here, 20 degrees comes from here, and then I have here the middle 21 for calculating here my control value. This is exactly the principle of the weighting. Okay, so we can do also some more diagnostic in the group monitor, but it's easier to use our ABB iBus tool for diagnostic. So I start now the ABB iBus tool. I need only the individual address of my fan coil controller, and click here on the button connect, and then the iBus tool makes a point-to-point connection and reads out my parameterization. With the iBus tool, I cannot change a parameter, I cannot make a download, I cannot link group addresses, it's only for commissioning and diagnostic. So in here you can see exactly the parameters which I have made in the ETS. You see he works as a controller, we see here our actual temperature, this depends on the weighting of our two temperatures, and the fan is in automatic mode. We are in the basic stage heating. We have 0% four pipe system. The window is not open. I can also test here. I open now the window and then you will see the status here. Yes, window is open. Good, this is in the status mode. Let's go to the control mode. And the control mode, I see at the moment, I'm in the operating mode. We are in the so-called heating mode and the comfort mode, comfort modes meet, the room is now occupied. When I click here the button, go to the echo mode, then you will see he follows, he is in the echo mode, and we have now a new set point temperature of 17 degrees. This means 4 kelvins, our relative, 21 minus 4, 17 degrees. So, or I change again here the mode, go back to my comfort mode. Or when I open the window, then you will see he goes into the frost protection mode. And we have a set point temperature of 7 kelvins. So I can also test here. Or I can change here also my set point, like for example, plus 0.5, so I can increase and I will see, yes, it works. Or here, for example, 22. And the steps 0.5 is a parameter and the ETS. Good, okay. This is also a principle of the controller, the operating modes. What I can do also is now the summer compensation. Remember, summer compensation, we go here into the cooling mode. So now go back to the cooling mode. You see the valve for cooling opens, fan speed number 3. You see here the snowflake, which shows us, gives us information we are in the cooling mode. Here we can see our actual temperature, 25 degrees and our set point. Oh, sorry, 25 degrees is our set point, and the room temperature here we have 30 degrees. So when I start now, I change my outside temperature. So I have here a second temperature sensor, and I simulate the outside temperature with another control element, which is not visible here. So in the next element, I send here, for example, a temperature of 30 degrees outside temperature. You see the set point is still 25. So I send now an outside temperature of 31 degrees. And what happens? You see the set point now changed from 25 degrees to 26. So this is the increasing of the temperature depending on the outside temperature. Or when I send here 32 degrees outside temperature, and then you will see the set point now increases to 27. So this is the principle of the summer compensation. So we have outside a higher temperature, and then the cooling set point in the comfort mode is now also increased. Or the temperature outside goes back, maybe for example to 30 degrees, and then you will see we use here 25. So this is exactly the principle of the summer compensation. Good, what else? Our startup behavior. So I go here to the outputs A, startup behavior. So here we can see the behavior of our thermoelectric valve drive for the output A, output B, and here our fan. So now we are in the cooling mode, 100%, the valve open, and we are on the fan speed number 3. So now when I reduce, for example, here my room temperature, like here, then it will go immediately into the fan speed number 2, 2 seconds later, and the fan speed number 1. Here we can see exactly this principle. Or again, I go back to fan speed number 3. So, and then I simulate here another room temperature. Then you will see he follows immediately my command. He goes in the fan speed number 2. Then he remains 2 seconds, and then he goes in the fan speed number 1. It's exactly this run-on behavior. Or when I switch off here on this button, then you will see he remains 4 seconds and the fan speed number 1 to blow the cold air out of the fan coil unit, and then he goes to 0. Good, then I switch on, and then you will see exactly the principle of the startup behavior. So I switch here on, he starts in the fan speed number 3, he remains 5 seconds and the fan speed number 3, and then he goes in the calculated fan speed, like here my fan speed number 1. That's the principle here of the startup behavior. It works in the, of course, in the cooling mode, and the same principle also in the heating mode. Good, so then I would like to show you the valve purge. Valve purge, we can use it automatically, for example, every 4 weeks via internal timer, or I can also trigger it via a group object, like via a timer, time switch. So now when I click here on this button, then what happens? The valve purge for my valve output A starts. You see the output under my valve starts, and here also the valve purge is now active. You see here the green icon. So the valve opens now one time, that it will not stuck, for example, during the summer time. Yeah, and then after this time we have set in the ETS, the valve closes automatically. It's a principle of the valve purge. And the last function is the manual override. So I go, for example, here back to my heating mode. I'm now in the heating mode, 20 degrees, my room temperature, my set point 21. Okay. So then I activate here the manual override, for example, via this button here. It's a 1-bit telegram. So I click here, and then the manual override is now active. So, and I have to send a value like 40 or 80%. So, or I can send it via the ETS group monitor, and then you will see the output follows exactly here my 40%, which are sent here by my button. And the fan goes exactly to the calculated position of my 40%, depending on my thresholds. Or I send here value of 80%, and then you will see the valve opens 80%, and the fans go in the span speed number 3. Go back to 40%, and so for testing or for function tests or maintenance, I can use this manual override functions for the valve output and also for the fan. Okay, So then, and we are one bit deactivated function. So far, the IBUS tool, maybe for displaying or for diagnostic. And I can use also the IBUS tool to send commands. So we have activate the configuration mode. And then by pressing here a button, like for example here, go into fan speed number 3, then I can override the calculated value, see the value is overwritten. And you see here on the output, he goes in fan speed number 3. Or I can also switch the fan here off. Then you will see the run on behavior. Fan speed number 2, 4 seconds in fan speed number 1, and then the fan switches off. By clicking on this X, he goes back to the automatic mode. Or for example, I can also enter here actual value. I can override here this calculated value, and I can enter, for example, here 87%, and then the output you see here is manually overwritten. The valve opens here 87% of this pulse width modulation time, and the fans goes in fan speed number 3. There's also a feature that we can override these values here in the IBUS tool temporarily. Good, so far I'm at the end now of my practical demonstration. Okay, a little bit more than 30 minutes of this additional room temperature functions, and I would like to say thank you for your participating and hand back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. Great. So we have seen the further very powerful functions of RTC control. You've seen it's quite useful to have sometimes trading boards, to have, of course, the ABB IBUS tool, very, very useful. And of course, also sometimes group monitoring should be used to see all the functions, to check something, to see how it works. So as we have seen, these RTC functions are not like on off only, it's some more, and all these things are very useful in this case. Okay, so no questions, and so then I can come quickly to my final slides. You know where to find everything about the products and our training material. All we have done in the past and which is done right now is in our training and qualification database on our homepage. Yeah, let's look to the have a look to the future. At the moment, we are a bit busy with some other things involved in projects, so we will postpone our originally planned further sessions around HVAC. Not so many anymore, but still some left. But it's not lost. We continue with this on time. We inform you if it's possible. But we have further sessions, of course. In June, July, we have also webinars again. And but we will invite you, of course, if it's continuing. So then I say thank you for your participation and wait for our next session. Thank you. Bye-bye. Ciao.